इंडस्ट्री को कैसे हार्नेस किया जाए, कैसे उसका लाभ उठाया जाए और ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा रोजगार क्रिएट किया जाए, इस भावना को लेके कंप्लीट मीडिया एंड एंटरटेनमेंट इंडस्ट्री में टेक्नोलॉजी के उपयोग से इस इंडस्ट्री को बढ़ावा देना और रोजगार ज़्यादा उत्पन्न करना, इस भावना के साथ वेव्स की एक कल्पना की गई है। ये ग्लोबल समिट जो इंटरनेशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल होता है गोवा में, उसके साथ ही किया जाएगा। मेरे साथ ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर गोवा है। इफ़ी और वेव्स मिलके एक तरीके से मीडिया एंड एंटरटेनमेंट इंडस्ट्री को बढ़ाने के लिए, ग्रो करने के लिए, एम्प्लॉयमेंट बढ़ाने के लिए एक बड़ा साधन बनेगा। इफ़ी एक तरीके से आउटपुट है और वेव्स इसमें इनपुट है। टेक्नोलॉजी और आज के जो लेटेस्ट टूल्स हैं और लेटेस्ट टैलेंट है उस सब के लिए।
सर, जो आप परमिशन कराए आज का सिस्टम पॉलिटिकल क्वेश्चन प्लीज।
वेव्स का मैं जो अभी मिनिस्टर इंफॉर्मेशन एंड ब्रॉडकास्टिंग से अश्विनी वैष्णव जी ने कहा है कि वेव्स 20 तारीख से 26 तारीख से में गोवा में इफ़ी के समय हो रहा है। मैं बहुत बहुत स्वागत करता हूँ। ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी जी का विजन मीडिया और एंटरटेनमेंट सोसाइटी को लेके इस तरह के उसको ज़्यादा बढ़ावा देना के लिए वेव्स फेस्टिवल, जो ग्लोबल फेस्टिवल, ग्लोबल समिट गोवा में करने जा रहा है, इसलिए मैं माननीय प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी और अश्विनी वैष्णव और उनकी मिनिस्ट्री की तरफ जो गोवा में आयोजन करने का उन्होंने जो सपना देखा है उसको मैं स्वागत करता हूं। और इफ़ी 20 साल से हम होस्ट कर रहे हैं, वेव्स भी इसी लेवल पे बहुत ग्लोबली सभी पार्टनर गोवा में आएंगे, उनका भी मैं बहुत बहुत स्वागत करता हूं।
सर, पिछली बार भी हमने देखा था कि
थैंक यू सर, वेव्स मी खूप खूप स्वागत करतो की पहिल्या वेळी की आपण आता मीडिया आणि एंटरटेनमेंट यासाठी जो वेव्स हा कार्यक्रम म्हणजे वेव्स हे इनपुट आणि इफी आउटपुट या धर्तीवरती आत्ता मिनिस्टर अश्विनी वैष्णवजीने सांगितले, त्याचं मी खूप खूप स्वागत करतो। मी गोवा सरकारच्या वतीने सगळ्यांना या कार्यक्रमासाठी इन्व्हाइट करतो।
With us and coming together, it's going to be a conference of cultures also, as we all are going to be coming together in Goa for the event, which is going to be the first Wave Summit, which is going to be unfolding there. And this is marking its auspicious beginning, inaugurating the fundraiser, which is going to be giving us a theme.
Cementing the collaboration, the partnership the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Government of India, and the Government of Goa, we have the exchange of MOU. I'd like to request Shri Sanjay Jadhuji, Respective Secretary, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, and Dr. Puneet Kumar Goyal, the Chief Secretary of Goa, to please exchange the MOU in the presence of our Honourable Ministers, Chief Minister Sir, and all the dignitaries, and all present here in this August gathering. This MOU, ladies and gentlemen, signifies a shared commitment towards excellence and growth. This is a landmark agreement marking the start of a new era of collaboration and prosperity. Sabke saath ke saath, sabke vishwas ke saath, sabke priyas ke saath, is industry ki growth aur prosperity, is manokamna ke saath, aur ichha shakti ke saath, is aur uchaiyon ko le jaane ki taraf ye Memorandum of Understanding अभी exchange किया गया, and now we all stand excited to be listening to our leader, the Honourable Minister of Information and Broadcasting, Shri Ashwini Vaishnavji, who also leads the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology and Railways. I invite you, sir.
Honourable Chief Minister of Goa, Shri Pramod Sawant ji, my colleague Minister Dr. Murugan ji, Chairman Trai, Shri Lahoti ji, Chief Secretary Goa, Shri Puneet Goyal ji, Secretary in the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Shri Sanjay Jaju ji, all the industry leaders, captains of media and entertainment industry, excellencies, and the friends from India. At the outset, I thank you all for being present in this curtain-raiser event for Waves in such a large number. I'm extremely keen to listen from the captains of industry who have connected here, who have joined this session for having a brainstorming on media and entertainment industry. Like my colleague, Honorable Chief Minister, invited you to AFI and Waves, I also extend you a very warm welcome for this path-breaking event, AFI and Waves, and this is going to be a significant milestone in India's media and entertainment industry's future development. I'll start my discussion or my address with the Honorable Prime Minister's vision in the entire technology sector and how that manifests, that vision manifests in other sectors where technology is the has become the backbone of the sector. As we all know, friends, the media and entertainment world is going through a structural change. Over the last two decades, if you look at the media and entertainment world, it has seen wave after wave of technology which has not only opened new opportunities but also caused concerns among some of the participants who have not been able to keep up with the change. The role of public policy and our Prime Minister's vision is we should be able to harness the best out of this structural change, and we should be able to support the people, support the industry, support the entire ecosystem of media and entertainment in coping up with the change in technology. So this requires a very nuanced way of looking at each and every fine detail in the industry. This requires a lot of effort on handholding, a lot of effort on creating the talent pool, a lot of effort in getting the right technologies. And that's what our Prime Minister's vision for the media and entertainment industry is. We would be focusing in the coming years and months in this third term of Prime Minister Modi ji, we would be focusing a lot on creating more employment in the media and entertainment industry. The employment in media and entertainment industry stands roughly around 25 lakh, today 2.5 million. Our effort has to be to increase it significantly. And to increase it significantly, we will be making some structural efforts and making some process efforts. The structural efforts would be aimed at developing an ecosystem where high quality content can be created, where IP rights can be developed in the country, where the world sees India as a natural place for establishing their content creation teams. In many of the global capability centers, GCCs that we have, we already have a very good experience. I have interacted with some of the major global media and entertainment houses who have their GCCs in India, and they have given a very solid thumbs up, a solid vote of confidence in our talent pipeline. So the structural effort will be how do we increase and further augment this talent pipeline? How do we have more and more mentorship programs? How do we build the capacity? How do we also get the tools which may be very difficult for individual small companies or startups? Can we create a structure where people get those expensive tools, get access to those expensive tools? And I'll give some examples on that. In the electronics industry, designing semiconductor chips requires very expensive tools. So So our Prime Minister, in his vision, he has always said that we should be able to democratize technology. So we created a system by which the tools are now available in 104 universities. So that means the students of these 104 universities are today getting access to the latest tools. Same process we adopted, same structural thing we adopted in telecom sector. 100 universities today have 5G labs. So that means the students and teachers and the researchers get access to really latest equipment. That process we will adopt in media and entertainment sectors. We have an example in the railway sector also, where Prime Minister's vision of creating a logistics focused university to impart the specialized knowledge in transportation and logistics, the Gati Shakti Vishwavidyalaya. Similar examples exist in other sectors also. So we adopt those best practices in the media and entertainment industry, so that the talent, skill and capacity building and education related to media and entertainment can be used as a forum, used as a path to generating more employment in the media and entertainment sector. Friends, we also know that IP right, the IP rights, they hold a huge value in the media and entertainment world. We will be strengthening the ecosystem for protecting IP rights, and we will also make sure that our rich culture and rich heritage and the vast history, the diverse languages, the diversity of our country gets manifested in the media and entertainment industry, and the IP rights of those are also protected in the proper way. These will be some of the major agenda items. The other important part will be, how do we create access to low cost funds? This is a very significant part of our drive, our effort towards structural improvements in the media and entertainment industry. And since this is an industry which is akin to a startup in terms of technology and finance world, we will have to create structures which basically learn from the technology world, the world of VC capital, and work out a solution which can really be applied to the world of media and entertainment. These are efforts which will require tremendous tenacity, lot of interaction between the media and the government, closely coordinated efforts between the media and entertainment, the financial world and the world of technology. These will require very well thought through policy interventions. And I hope that in the coming months and years, the industry and the government will work very closely towards making these efforts successful. We will also focus, friends, on gender and social inclusion. As you all know, Prime Minister Modi's 10 years, the first two terms, have presented one of the most inclusive government, one of the most inclusive development model, which probably in a country of this magnitude, with such a large population, it's nowhere seen in the world. Millions and billions of people have got the benefits which they would have not even thought of 10 years before. For example, 110 million toilets being constructed in the rural areas. For example, almost 100 million cooking gas cylinders, cooking gas connections, 40 million houses getting constructed in the rural areas. 500 million bank accounts opened, and at least around half of them are accounts held by women in the rural areas. That kind of inclusive growth is unheard of in human history. And that focus on equality, on social inclusion, on having an inclusive growth where the people and people who are conventionally marginalized from the mainstream of the society also get the opportunity to be part of the mainstream, also get the opportunity to be part of this growth journey. That is a major focus for Prime Minister Modi ji throughout his public service, throughout his tenure in Gujarat and as the Prime Minister of India for 2 terms. That same focus will remain in the government also. Friends, I'll close my address with a very small, since I come from the, say, I'm a student of finance and technology, so I tend to use those symbols and those analogies. IFFI is the output. IFFI is the output and waves is the input. So waves is the technology, the creative landscape, the tools used for that, and that's why I thank Honorable Chief Minister of Goa for agreeing to hold waves as part of IFFI, so that input and output can come together and Goa can become a major hub of creative energy, creative talent. Please give a big round of applause to Chief Minister of Goa for his excellent work. And I look forward to welcome you all along with my colleague Dr. Murugan and CM Goa at the Feet and Wave Center. Thank you very much. Wish you all the best.
The dates, you know, the place, the countdown has already begun, and we all stand excited towards our journey together as we transcend in Goa. And we have the Mezban Chief Minister of Goa, Shri Pramod Sawant ji, present with us personally here to be inviting you all to be coming to Goa. So I request and invite Shri Pramod Sawant ji to please address this exciting and very enthusiastic gathering.
Before starting my speech, I welcome all of you for the IFFI and Waves from the 20th of November to 28th of November for the IFFI and 20th of November to the 24th of November for the Waves. For the curtain raiser ceremony of the Waves, along with me, Sri Ashwini Vaishnavji, Minister of the Information and Broadcasting, State Minister Sri L. Murugandhi, Secretary for the Information and Broadcasting, Chairman Tri, Puneet Kumar, the CS of Goa, and Joint Secretary. All the distinguished dignitaries among the audience, industry members and associates, the media representatives and esteemed guests, the ambassadors from various countries. It's my pleasure to welcome you all to this curtain raiser for the World Audiovisual Entertainment Summit, Waves, set to be held alongside 55th International Film Festival of India, IFFI in Goa. This is the Goa. Your presence here today underscores the importance of this gathering, and I extend my heartfelt gratitude for your support. This year, we are celebrating 20 years of hosting the prestigious International Film Festival of India, IFFI in Goa. Hosting this illustrious event is a source of immense pride for us. Goa, with its rich cultural heritage and scenic beauty, is a haven for creativity and artistic expression. The place has been a perfect setting for the more than 100 films in the last decade alone. Our state is a vibrant participant in the global dialogue on art and entertainment. The warm and welcome environment of the Goa makes it perfect setting for the international gathering like Waves and IFFI. Indian cinema is evolving rapidly. In 2023, India has made a significant impact on the global cinema since by winning the 2 Oscars for Arara and The Elephant Whispers, highlighting the power of the regional cinema on a global scale. This year at the 2024, the Cannes Film Festival, India has achieved further acclaim by winning the Grand Prix and the second highest honor, along with the first Best Actress Award and a 2 prize in the last cine category. As you are aware, the India is one of the largest film producing countries in the world, with an average of the 2,000 films released every year. Around 1,796 films were released in theatres in 2023 and across the different language and dubbed version, with the majority of them in the regional languages. On OTTs, almost 3,000 hours of the fresh original content was produced for streaming platform, of which 52% was in the regional languages. This is the power of the regional cinema. In this era of the content fungibility, a regional is a national. The animation, the visual effects and the post-production segment in India is another segment with a greater potential. The establishing AVG studios and startup can be positioned and provide a creative hub, attracting the investment and skilled professionals. The local artists and the graphic designers in Goa are increasingly venturing into the animation, the visual effects and gaming, leveraging their creativity and technical skills to support the AVGC sector. New media is also present opportunities for the growth in Goa. The state diverse and dynamic environment provides the ample opportunities for the digital content creation. Establishing the innovation hub and incubators can support startups and entrepreneurs in the new media space, driving economic growth. Goa boasts the wealth for the local talent that can signify the support the flourishing media and entertainment industry. The state is a home to the vibrant community of creative professionals who bring the unique blend of the cultural heritage and modern innovation to their work. Local filmmakers and production teams have gained recognition of their work in the regional cinema and showcasing the stories that resonate with both the local and global audience. The musician in Goa, influenced by the state's rich cultural musical traditions and contemporary styles, contributes to the dynamic musical scene. This includes everything from the traditional Goan folk music to the modern electronic music, making Goa as a melting pot for the musical talent. The music industry has a strong presence in Goa and with the renowned musical festival attracting the global audience. Furthermore, Goa's educational institutions and training programs are dedicated to nurturing the new talent in the various aspects of the media and entertainment industry. I encourage and invite all industry members to come to Goa, collaborate and set up your studios here. With the support of the industry association like FICCI, we can facilitate these initiatives. We are dedicated to supporting your business endeavor, ensuring that Goa evolves into the thriving hub for the media and entertainment industry. The Waves will be the key event that will eventually shape the futures of India's media and entertainment industry. The government of Goa remains steadfast in the commitment to supporting the industry and thus the country's growth. The synergy between the Waves and IFFI this year amplifies the impact of both the events. While IFFI has long been beacon for the cinematic excellence, the Waves introduced a new dimension for the industry collaboration by focusing on an emerging segment of the industry shaping the futures of media and entertainment. Together, this event creates a platform that honors the tradition while embarking the future, offering the unparalleled opportunities, the networking, learning and the growth. This event will be the aim further establishing Goa as a leading cultural hub. industry associations such as FICCI and CII play a pivotal role in fostering the industry partnership and addressing the challenges faced by the sector. They came closely, the work closely with the government to shape the more conducive policy and regulate the landscape, ensuring the sustainable growth and development for the film and entertainment industry. I'm very happy to note that the key role being played by the association in organizing the WAVES also. I extend the warm invitation to industry professionals, filmmakers, content creators, and technology experts to join us at WAVES. I encourage all the participants to make the most of the opportunities to connect, innovate, and push the boundaries of what is possible in the media and entertainment industry. I extend my heartfelt thanks for the Ministry of the Information and Broadcasting, industry association partners, the media representative, and all the stakeholders for their unwavering dedication and support in planning the event of this scale. I seek your active support and cooperation in coming months to ensuring this event grand success. I express my deepest gratitude to all of you for your support and enthusiasm. Let us move forward in the spirit of the innovation and collaboration to make WAVES 2024 an unforgettable and impactful event. Goa ne keval duniya ka sabse khoobsurat tourist destination nahi hai balki film nirman karne ka bhi kendra hai. Bollywood ka koi prasiddh film ho, shooting ho या समंदर के शानदार बीच, फ्लूट्स, ग्रीनरी और गोवा का कल्चर फिल्म निर्माताओं को आकर्षित करता है। सन, सैंड एंड सी के अलावा भी गोवा में बहुत कुछ देखने लायक है, इसीलिए मैं आप सभी को गोवा में इनवाइट करता हूँ कि गोवा आओ, वेव्स और इफ्फी दोनों में पार्टिसिपेट करो, जो दिल को भाए दिल न दुखाए वही एंटरटेनमेंट कहलाए। वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू फॉर ईपी एंड वेव्स।
श्री संजीव सुंदर, जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन ब्रॉडकास्टिंग ऑफिसर फ्रॉम द इंफॉर्मेशन ब्रॉडकास्टिंग। एवर ईयर अवर इंटरनेशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल गोवा इज एनहांसिंग न्यू ideas, items. Our International Film Festival is having film festival, film bazaars, books, postcards. So this year, the new enrichment of WAVES is going to air in our International Film Festival. This WAVES World Audio Visual Entertainment Summit is the our Prime Minister's Sri Narendra Modi ji's vision to bring all the global leaders in the entertainment, media and entertainment sector in India, particularly in Goa. I met few international film festivals I joined with our Chief Minister of Gujarat, Goa. So every year he put so many initiatives, efforts, and to bring the festival is very successful. So this year the Goa government, they come forward to air this our WAVES. Our Minister Sri Aswin Vaishnav ji's new things and his guidance, this WAVES and our Minister's vision is that, our Ministry's vision is that Bharat, our India is the hub of the country. So we have the content, we have content creators. Now these WAVES, audiovisual, VFS, animation, because of our Indian manpower, that is skilled manpower. Already some films, post-production work, some Hollywood films post-production work is taking place in Hyderabad, in Mumbai, in Bangalore, in Chennai. Because of our IT engineers, skilled manpower, so we are marching towards. So in this juncture, this new waves is going to play a huge, major role to develop rising Indians place. The content is the main thing. In recent days, I don't know whether I can mention the cinema name or not, but I can mention. Why the content is good, the film will be very big, very successful. Manjumal Boys. And cinema is very normal cinema, but low budget cinema. But content is very good, very nice content. So the film is now so popular. So like the India is already, we are the player for the content. From Mahabharata, from Ramayana. So our content, our Itihas stories, our content is there. As well as our government already initiated Shoot in India. So we have good natural places, mountains, forests, as well as good beaches. So for that already we had a collaboration with the global players, with the Indian film producers, come and shoot in India. For that, our single window system, you need not to go to anywhere to get approval. The single place you can get approval. So the transparency and simplicity, simplify, we brought. And one more thing, recent last parliament session, we brought amendments in the Cinema Photography Act to protect from the virus. So we are always, our government is support to the cinema industry as well as the entertainment sector. So now in this juncture, our waves, because of the technology, because of the evaluation of the new artificial intelligence and VFS, in a sense. So the Indian cinemas is going forward. I congratulate our secretary and the officers who take this initiative to this cut and raise up program, this function. I once again congratulate you all. Thank you very much for joining this program.
Okay, sir. And ladies and gentlemen, the lamp
Triel Muruganji, Chairman of TRAI, Lahoti ji, esteemed friend, Chief Secretary Goa, Puneet ji, our Joint Secretary handling this event, members of the industry, members of the media, of course here media and the industry remains synonymous, and ladies and gentlemen, and also our esteemed ambassadors, heads of missions, emotions, and what you term as currently as the entertainment industry has been part of our ethos. And it's indeed a very significant moment today that we have all gathered here to have the curtain raiser unveil the logo for the first World Audiovisual and Entertainment Summit, which we are all fondly calling as WAVES, to be held in the picturesque setting of Goa from 20th November till 24th November 2024 on the sidelines of the International Film Festival of India. And this is going to add an amazing chapter and feather to the illustrious history of the media and the entertainment segment in our country. Friends, this summit is not just another event on the calendar. It's a visionary initiative led by the Honorable Prime Minister, started off from the comments made and the directions issued by our Honorable Prime Minister to have a world-class global media and entertainment summit. His idea was to look at India's soft prowess and ensure that as we grow economically and become the third largest economy in few years, our soft power also grows in a similar vein. And friends, this entire segment is to look at India as a global leader in this dynamic landscape of media and entertainment. The idea is that this summit should set new benchmarks in creativity, innovation, and influence. And it will be bringing together the brightest minds, the industry leaders, innovators from across the globe to explore opportunities, tackle challenges, and shape the future of this sector. Friends, this summit will be, as I mentioned, a confluence of ideas. It will be a crucible for knowledge exchange, and it will also become a catalyst for meaningful collaborations that will allow this industry to propel forward. We have set for ourselves a series of objectives when it comes to waves. Let me list few of them. First and foremost would be to foster innovation and technological advancement. All of you would agree that this sector sees a huge advent of cutting-edge technologies and innovative practices. The idea is for us to ensure that we showcase such technological advancements which can revolutionize not just content creation, but at the same time its distribution and also its consumption. The second objective will be to enhance the global competitiveness of our industry, position India as a leading player in the global landscape, and there we are going to highlight our capabilities in content creation, in segments like animation, VFX, gaming, and the attempt would be to showcase the qualitative improvement and ensure that our product has a global appeal. The third would be the idea to have industry collaborations to facilitate partnerships and to allow content creators, technology providers, investors and policy makers to sit together and thereby create a synergistic environment for growth and investments. Investments is one of the segments which this edition of Waves is going to be looking at, not just the domestic but as well as the international investments in this burgeoning industry. No industry can survive without the skill sets, and India with its demographic dividend and a huge talent and technological pool is firmly poised to tackle this challenge. Waves will ensure that skill development and nurturing new talent remains a cornerstone of its strategy. Content diversity for a country like ours is an equally important objective, and two waves will try and see if we can appeal to both the domestic as well as the international audience and also support content in multiple languages and promote regional stories on the global platform. Sustainable growth will be another objective that we intend to meet out to waves, especially to focus on environmentally friendly practices and responsible use of resources for ensuring long-term sustainability. Friends, the global media and entertainment industry has a staggering revenue of close to $2.5 trillion. India also has a huge market size of close to about $25 billion, close to about 2.5 lakh crore is the size of the industry. But we also stand on the cusp of an exponential growth in this particular segment. This summit is going to offer us opportunities to expand our global footprint as well as drive revenue growth and position India as a global leader in this particular segment. In terms of the opportunities and growth segments through waves, we are looking at content production and innovation to be one of the important pillars. animation, VFX and gaming is another segment that we are looking at with a lot of vigor. And music and intellectual property creation is also going to be an important segment in our WAVE journey this year. If we look forward to WAVE, what are the major areas and focus areas, especially for our industry? Digital transformation, as I just now mentioned, skill development, infrastructure development, which is an important aspect to support high quality content production and distribution, global collaborations, content localization, and sustainable practices, as I mentioned. The kind of activities we are looking at in this edition of WAVES would not just include the plenary sessions, conferences, workshops, masterclasses. We'll also have policy roundtables, business to business interactions, exhibitions, because that's where the latest technologies, innovations and content could be showcased across the world. It will also allow space for networking, learning and discovering new opportunities. Media marketplace would be another part of this year's WAVE edition. And obviously, if you have entertainment, you can't keep cultural evenings apart. You will have cultural evenings which celebrate the rich cultural history of our great country. In terms of the stakeholders, a little part, small part of it is represented today in this particular edition of the Curtain Raiser. You have the content creators on one side, who actually are the central pillar when it comes to an entertainment segment. Then you have the technology providers, you have the investors, you have the policy makers, then the educators and trainers, the media houses and broadcasters, and the global giants. All this will ensure that there are enough business-to-business opportunities available for all of you in this edition of WAVES. The idea is to leverage the strengths that we have acquired through the International Film Festival of India and build them through this very important industry event called WAVES. And that is where this event is a unique event. It's an endeavor which is being led by the ministry, but it's supported completely by the industry and at every stage of its development, industry will be in the focal point when it comes to taking the WAVES forward. Before I conclude, I must thank the Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, Shri Pramod Sawantji, for his support and partnership in organizing this inaugural edition of WAVES in Goa. The Government of Goa's unwavering support for IFFI over the years and now for WAVES has been and will always be instrumental in organizing these events. It's no exaggeration to say that Goa can be termed as the entertainment industry capital of our country, and we look forward to continuous support coming in from the Government of Goa. Friends, once again I'd like to thank all of you for taking time on a busy week and coming as it is before the budgetary announcements come in. I understand how important these days are for the industry, but you have all taken time and you have all become part of this historic event, and I'm sure this will ensure that all of us together, with your continuous support and participation, will ensure that the media and the entertainment industry in our country, which has huge economic and employment potential, continues to grow and allow us, allow our country, allow Bharat to showcase its soft prowess and its soft presence across the world. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir, for giving us a very comprehensive account of WAVES 2024. And ladies and gentlemen, this event is going to be unfolding just a few months from now. I'm sure all of you stand excited to know the dates, though the respected secretary sir did mention about it. But yes, these dates were imprinted in your mind. So I would like to request our Honourable Minister, sir, Shri,
WAVES 2024. Ladies and gentlemen, the logo of WAVES, the design, if you see, coming up here on your screens, this is a vibrant, multicolored, ship-shaped like a peacock, India's national bird, symbolizing beauty, creativity, and cultural pride.
The ship which appears to be sailing on a serene sea is constructed from an array of diverse visual elements. The collage,
storytelling heritage from Jhara and Gatha to Yesda, contemporary and modern films, continues to thrive and evolve. International Film Festival of India has played a primary and most significant role in enhancing and magnifying the journey of cinema. Established in 1952, International Film Festival of India has grown to become one of the world's most prestigious film festivals, where cinema comes to life in its most diverse and captivating forms. It has served as a platform of creativity that has paved the way where India is poised to stand in front of the world as a global leader. The Indian media and entertainment sector has seen a remarkable growth of over 8% in 2023 to cross ₹2.3 trillion. To take India's media and entertainment industry to new heights and expand its global footprint with icons of this fraternity across the world, focusing on entertainment, economics and technology, fueled the idea of organizing the first World Audiovisual and Entertainment Summit, WAVES. Nestled between the serene shores of Goa and the vibrant backdrop of the International Film Festival of India and Film Bazaar, WAVES unfolds from 20th to the 24th of November, aiming to leverage cutting-edge technologies, encouraging cross-cultural understanding and knowledge exchange, and tapping into new markets. WAVES is a platform to explore myriad opportunities in the media and entertainment sector worldwide, from news, advertising, radio and television to music, animation, VFX, gaming and comics to OTT, digital media, AI and metaverse. WAVES is a confluence of 10 plus industries coming together under one roof. WAVES is more than a summit. It's a platform where creativity meets commerce, tradition meets innovation, and ideas ignite opportunities. It brings to you conferences, business events, exhibitions, media and content marketplace, skills and talent showcase, and cultural extravaganza to celebrate the vibrant diversity and technological prowess of India's media and entertainment industry. Explore India's fast-growing capabilities in VFX, animation and gaming. Engage with global thought leaders and explore sessions designed to reveal the future of media and entertainment. Witness the largest conference of media and entertainment professionals, where every corner of the industry converges to forge partnerships, discuss policies and showcase innovations. WAVES is where new paths are forged and existing ones are expanded. Join us at WAVES to connect, collaborate and create with the best in the industry.
That, ladies and gentlemen, is the World WAVES 2024, and we now introduce you to the official website of WAVES. I would like to request Dr. M. Murugan sir, the Honorable Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting, to please release the website, which is the website with the click of the remote. This is serve as a hub of information and engagement, offering a sneak peek into the summit's exciting sessions, showcasing our illustrious speakers and providing opportunities for networking and collaboration. You can also meander through our exhibition showcase, engage with our community, register for WAVES, register a few clicks. You have website, as you see, the major activities showcasing those sub-events which are going to be organized, the news and the updates, all featured here. That's the photo gallery. You can
giving you a sneak peek into the grandeur of this event. We have the social media corner, online registrations you can make through this website. And then there's a very user-friendly website, easy to register yourself, and all the information going into it, all the details in this website which has been just now released. All happening just with the click of a button. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have the release of the brochure, which offers a comprehensive overview of what to expect at Waves 2024. I would like to request all the dignitaries of the day to please release the brochure. This curtain raiser event, we extend maximum information about the summit. We had the website and the logo released, and now we have the brochure which is being released. And this brochure, ladies and gentlemen, highlights the key themes, the exciting lineup of speakers, the unique experiences that await our attendees, encapsulating all the excitement and innovation that the summit promises to bring up. So a quick look at the brochure, which has been placed on your screens. Thank you, dignitaries. And now we look forward to the views and the address of our honorable Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting. I request Dr. Edna Rubinstein to please address this on this campaign.
Respected Sri Ashwin Vaishnavji, honorable Minister for Information and Broadcasting, Minister of Railways, Information Technology, Respected Sri Pramod Sawantji, Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, Respected Sri Anil Kumar Bhatiaji, Chairman Troy, Dr. Anil Kumar Goyalji, Chief
Dignitaries, wounded eyes, and offended eyes, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon to all. So this is not the end, actually this is the beginning of what is a Thanksgiving. And Thanksgiving is an important part because we have to acknowledge all those who have been behind this one-hour event, but preparations have been going on for very long. So, sir, I stand here. It is my honor today to extend a vote of thanks on behalf of my behalf as well as on behalf of the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting at this curtain raiser event for the first World Audiovisual and Entertainment Summit called Waves. Sir, the event has invoked a sense of great excitement and optimism for what lies ahead. So, four months from now, come November, and WAVE will take place alongside the prestigious IFFI, that is the International Film Festival of India, in the picturesque state of Goa. This curtain raiser event is our commitment to the vision of WAVES. And this will provide a mature and strategic platform for the global aviation, innovation and collaboration in the whole media and entertainment industry. Sir, we aspire to bring together the brightest minds and the most influential voices from across the world to share insights, explore new business opportunities, and chart the future course of this dynamic industry.
Sir, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to our Honorable Minister of Information and Broadcasting, Shri Ashwini Vaishnav, sir, for his visionary leadership and kind support, without which this ambitious initiative would not have been possible. I also wish to express my sincere appreciation to the Honorable Chief Minister of Goa for graciously hosting IFFI in the beautiful state of Goa over the years, and also kindly consented to host WAVES this year and then. Sir, your support and hospitality have made Goa a choice destination for artists, filmmakers and creative minds from around the world. Our special thanks to Honorable Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting, Dr. Alan Murugan, for his continued support and providing the guiding leadership in bringing up the idea of WAVES. We are grateful to Honorable Chairman Trai, Sri Hari Kumar Rawati sir, for his constructive role leading to promotion and growth of media and entertainment industry and his gracious presence today. Our thanks to Chief Secretary Goa, Sri Puneet Kumar Goyal for his kind and active support for the event and gracious presence in today's event. Our sincere thanks to Secretary, Minister of Information and Broadcasting, Sri Sanjay Jadhav sir, for his 24/7 support, engagement, encouragement and invaluable guidance in mediating WAVES as an unparalleled platform for industry collaborations. Thank you very much, sir. Many thanks to Your Excellencies, Ambassadors, Chargé d'Affaires, diplomats of foreign missions present today for gracing this occasion and signaling the commitment to global collaboration for this audiovisual industry. Thank you very much, Your Excellencies. I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge the invaluable assistance of our partners, the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, FICCI, CII, NFDC, BESIP, who have always been the forefront of promoting growth of media and entertainment industry. I thank industry associations in supporting the ministry in organizing this curtain raiser. I extend my heartfelt thanks to the esteemed industry members present here today. Your insightful perspectives and expertise have always enriched our discussions and provided us with a wealth of knowledge to carry forward. We also extend our gratitude to the media for this extensive coverage and support for this event. I must also acknowledge the very generous support of JSMEA and his team in reaching out to the foreign missions in India. Thank you, Mr. Jaiswal. My heartfelt thanks to the officers and staff of Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, its media units, and particularly the team of very dedicated officers, Dipali Sharma, Captain Saurabh Chauhan, Ajay Agarwal, Ajay Lokhe, the EMA Pavilion and Interiors, and each and every member of the organizing team and support teams. We are very grateful to the senior leadership of the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, AS, JSS, and everybody in the ministry. As we stand just 4 months away from this grand event, I urge all stakeholders to come together and contribute towards making WAVES a resounding success. Let us use the coming months to learn from global leaders, foster new collaborations and inspire each other to ensure the grand success of WAVES. I once again thank each and every one of you for your gracious presence here today and your continued support. Thank you, and we look forward to seeing you all at WAVES Goa in November. Thank you very much.